MLB The Show's coverage of Major League Baseball is on the air. Ought to be a good one here between the Toronto Blue Jays and the New York Yankees. Almost time for these two to square off right after this. Gerrit Cole is ready to go as he'll be on the mound for the Yanks. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Matt, I'm a big fan of Gerrit Cole. Big, strong guy. Former first-round draft pick out of UCLA. 96 to 98 miles an hour with sink. Hard slider. His changeup has gotten better the longer he's pitched. He has a chance to be a no-hit type of pitcher every time he takes the mound.
At the plate, Bo Bichette. He will lead this one off today. Bichette. Late swing there at the breaking ball. Must have been looking for something else.
First pitch, 1 o'clock.
One strike now from Cole. And this ball's heading for the seats down the right side as the count will move to 0-2 now. Nothing in two count and the pitch.
One ball, two strikes.
Yeah. Game time temperature this afternoon stuck in an even 50 degrees as we begin play. The 1-2. Misses, ball two. Fouled away. The 2-2 one more time is looked at and the count moves full. Marcus Semien is on deck. The 3-2 pitch. And that misses, ball four. So a good battle to begin the ball game today, but the leadoff man will reach first anyway.
And that's just an incredible job at the plate by the leadoff man there. Not only did he make the pitcher throw a ton of pitchers and bust his tail, but he also won the battle and earned a free pass.
At the plate, Marcus Semien, his career line against Gerrit Cole. He's gone just 2 for 15. He also has one home run. First offering on its way. Time to check our umpires in this one. Behind the plate is Freddie Ferguson.
You know, this is one of the guys behind the dish, Freddie Ferguson, Dan, that the rookies are going to have a tough time with. If you've played in the league for a little bit, you understand that he's got his own zone.
You touched on it, D-Roy. I think he rewards the veteran players, not only pitchers, but position players. He makes the younger players, he makes them earn their keep.
Semien is a strong defender playing up the middle in the infield. He's got great hands, good range, the big arm, and those skills are not lost on his teammates, his coaches, or his front office for that matter.
Yeah, he has the ability. What I love about this ball player, he's got such a great internal clock. It seems like it's bang bang at first every time, but the guy's out. He's got sure hands and an accurate throwing arm.
Here's George Springer. No one on base for him after the double play.
Yeah, Matt, that two ball really changed the complexion of this inning. It looked like the middle of the order was going to have a chance to get a big hit with some ducks on the pond, but now they just have to try and get a two-out rally started.
Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. And here's a fastball called for strike one. And he falls behind 0-2. Slider whiffed on for strike three. A great pitch to put an end to the inning. Down in order go the Blue Jays. Blue Jays nothing, Yankees coming to bat. Major League Baseball on the show. Hyunjin Ryu, the Korean lefty, will be the starter in this one. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Well, Matt, he reminds me, he's the closest thing that I've seen to David Wells. You watch him throw, he's 89 to 93 miles an hour, kind of a big, loopy, overhand curveball, does have the hard slider and the changeup. A good athlete for a big guy. You'll know if he's on early. He has to get his breaking pitches over to make his fastball effective.
Now at the plate, Gio Urshela. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Ball one to start the at-bat. Into his windup, here comes the 1-0. Hey! Can't connect there. It's 2-2.
Hey, I'd like to see a little bit more discipline in that. You get a count in your favor and swinging a pitch that bad? Not good.
Hard hit ball to short. And there's one down now.
Batting second, the designated hitter, Clint Frazier.
So the base is empty here with one away, and that'll bring up the outfielder Clint Frazier. First delivery to him on the way. And a fastball is in there for strike one.
Very rarely does a pitcher like this leave one in a location like that. That's a pitch right there he'd like to have back. He'd love to swing at that one again.
The windup and the 0-1. There's a changeup taken, but it finds the zone on the inside.
I get it. He wants to see this guy's repertoire, but now he's behind in the count. Puts himself in a tough spot to hit.
And they'll try to bounce a curveball on 0-2, but he holds back. It's 1-2 now.
He didn't look overly fooled right there because a lot of pitchers will go to the breaking stuff 0-2, but he certainly looked ready for a breaker on that pitch.
Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
He's not going to feel good about that at bat, nor should he. You have to want to swing the bat, but he just stood there and looked at four straight pitches. Hopefully, we'll see him get a little bit more aggressive next time.
Here's the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu. As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one, looking to get on base and keep this first inning alive. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Now he turns and smokes this one into deep center field. Springer is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. Yankees come up empty. We've played an inning in the Bronx. No score here on the show. New inning set to get underway. And next will be a speed threat in the form of outfielder Teoscar Hernandez. First pitch on its way.
1-0.
Hey, it looks like this guy's going to work in the upper part of the strike zone. It'll be interesting to see if this lineup can adjust to the way he pitches.
Swing and a miss on the fastball, and it's 1-2.
He got a swing and a miss on that last pitch, but that's not the location he wants to live in against a hitter of this quality.
Fouled off. The 1-2 is swung on and missed, strike three.
It's always nice to keep a guy that has good wheels off base, and that's just what they did right there. Big strikeout, keep that guy off the base path.
Guerrero Jr.
At the plate, Vladimir Guerrero Jr. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. A ball and a strike. That fastball was a lively one. You could hear the pop of the glove all the way up here.
Hey, I admit I'm a little biased. There's nothing better than that pop of a glove on a good fastball. Looking forward to hearing a lot more of that pop the rest of this one.
The 1-1 is taken for ball two.
Great job to be able to lay off that pitch right there. You could tell the minute it came out of his hand, his eyes lit up at the plate.
And he can't catch the corner here, so he's behind 3-1. Lourdes Gurriel waits on deck. Hey. 3-1 pitch is a slider, and he can't pull the trigger. It's 3-2 now. Right side. And that is going to sneak on through into right. It's a one-out single.
Sometimes you get lucky in this game. I don't think pitch recognition wise he would choose to swing at that exact pitch, but you know what? Sometimes result is the only thing that matters.
In now, Lourdes Gurriel, as he'll take a look at ball one. First shot for him here with a runner at first now and one away. Ball and no strikes. Here it is.
That's out.
Clearly working the bottom of the zone, trying to get a ground ball for a double play.
Now Cole's delivery 2-0. Hey. Two balls and a strike.
Look at the radar gun on that slider. Off speed pitch, 91 miles an hour. That's just pure filth.
No score here as we play inning number two. Runners on the move for second. Offered at and missed. Here's the throw. Is right there on a perfect throw by Chirinos.
Well, so much for that first hit of the game. Tried to press their luck and move him up to second with a steal, but it didn't work out.
This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. LeMahieu's got it. Throw on to Voit takes care of him, and the inning is over. Nothing doing for the Blue Jays. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Now in the box, Luke Voit.
For the Yankees, the first baseman, Luke.
First pitch coming. Here it is.
1-0.
Ryu now on 2-1. And it's fouled away. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first out.
You know what was really impressive to me about that strikeout? He fell behind 2-0 to start the at bat. That's a pretty bad place to be, but then he kind of refocused himself and came right back with three quality pitches in a row to sit him down. That's not easy to do, but now his focus has to hone in on getting ahead on the next guy.
And digging into the batter's box next will be Giancarlo Stanton. As he'll wait out a breaking pitch here that finds the zone for strike one. On its way, the 0-1 pitch.
Nope. Ryu has both great strikeout stuff and exceptional command on the mound to go with it. A rare combination, but one that makes him one of the best in our sport.
Matty V, you talked about it. He doesn't walk a whole lot of guys. Well, if you don't walk a lot of guys, that means you have to throw the ball in the strike zone. And when you do, with great stuff like this guy has, he racks up the strikeouts. There aren't a lot of guys that get strikeouts by throwing the ball in the strike zone. This is one of the few that does it.
Count even at 2-2. Two-two pitch is fouled away. Bottom of the second here with no score. Not close with that one. It's way above the strike zone.
To be honest with you, I'm a little bit more afraid of the guy on deck than the guy that's up right now. If I'm on the mound, I want this guy up right now. He's the guy that's got to beat me.
Full count still. Grounder down the line at third. And a diving effort, but it's out of his reach. A foul ball. This is lifted out to left. Gurriel is right there as he'll put it away without much problem for the second out.
Batting fifth.
Here's big Aaron Judge. He'll try to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Just off the outside, and it's 1-0. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side. Simeon is there, and the side is retired. So the Yanks go 1-2-3. We'll move to the third with no score. Rowdy Tellez the next to bat, as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one.
Number 44.
Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. Swing and a miss, and he's behind 0-1. One ball and one strike to their designated hitter this afternoon.
Hey, there's not a lot you can do with a slider breaking down and in unless you catch it way out front. I like the idea of taking it and making the pitcher bring you something a little more hittable.
And he takes a called strike two. Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first out.
Man, I love watching a pitcher that just rears back and blows smoke by a guy at the letters. That's the ultimate challenge pitch. And for me personally, watching hitters swing and miss, man, that's a sight of beauty.
At the plate now, Alejandro Kirk. He grounds it sharply to third, fielded cleanly, and quickly there are two away.
Batting nine.
Digging in, Kevin Biggio. He'll get to take his first cuts here.
Biggio.
The pitch. Good late break to the slider here, but he takes it in on the hands for ball one. Look out, 2-0 now.
It's never advantageous to fall behind 2-0 as a pitcher, but if you're going to do it, it's far better to do it with a guy down in the bottom of the order. Time for a challenge fastball right here, though.
Now here's the pitch. 3-0 now.
That's a good job right there. You very rarely see pitchers double up where they go a pitch inside. Normally, they'll go back outside, but he followed that up with another pitch on the inside part of the plate.
In there, 3-1. Oh. Swung on and missed 3-2.
What I love right there is just the freedom in that hack. He ain't trying to do anything but hit the baseball as far as he can.
He got him. Lively fastball that time, and it puts an end to the inning. Blue Jays go down in order. Home half of the third coming up. No score. Digging in now for the Yankees, Robinson Chirinos, 7, 8, and 9 to start the home third.
Not much going on offensively so far for these guys. Six up, six down. We'll see if the bottom part of the lineup can get something going.
Well, the home crowd seems a little restless, so I'm sure they'd appreciate it. First offering on its way. Well below the knees, laid off on the changeup there. Little chopper back to the mound. And the throw to first is in time, one gone. Standing in, Torres.
Shortstop, Labor. Torres.
First delivery to him on the way. Swung on and missed. It's 0-1. Yankees still on the lookout for hit number one here. Ball one. Fastball close, but he didn't get it. 2-1. And a swing and a miss, as that looked like self-defense there. It's 2-2.
Not much you could do with that one. Tied him up in knots.
The 2-2 is swung on and missed. He got him.
Nice two-seam fastball there. You don't usually see a lot of swings and misses with that pitch unless it's really moving. So that one must have had some real good late life.
Standing in now, Aaron Hicks. He swings and hits it foul off to the right and out of play. Bottom of inning number three, nothing our score.
That's a ball.
And low, it's a ball and a strike.
One ball, one strike.
And he just misses inside with the fastball there. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. Two balls and two strikes now. The 2-2. High in the air and drifting out to shallow center. Simeon ranging into the outfield. He's there to track it down, and that'll end the inning. 1-2-3 go the Bombers. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless. Back to the top of the order now, and into bat next, the legacy, Bo Bichette.
This game is rolling right along as we move into the middle innings with no score. You'd think by now one of these two teams would be able to get some base runners on and get him in, but that hasn't been the case.
There's a fastball pretty close that time, but ruled a ball, 1-1. Blue Jays shortstop with a 1-2 count. Now here it comes. And this is swung on and missed, and this fourth inning will start the same way he ended the third, with a strikeout, and there's one away.
Now batting, the second baseman.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Marcus Semien. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Fastball in there for a called strike.
That elevated fastball right there, that is the biggest change in the game today for me. When I first came up, a lot of guys working that Greg Maddux east to west.
This is chopped down the third baseline, but that'll get foul. It's 0-2 now. Nothing in two count, and the pitch.
Outside, that's a ball.
Boy, he sped him up in this at-bat. Now it's time for the changeup. This guy's got a good one, and he hasn't thrown it yet in this at-bat.
No runs, just one hit, and no errors in the game for Toronto. And the slider gets him swinging, two gone.
Pretty impressive back-to-back strikeouts to start the inning. What's even more important is now he gets to face the middle of the order without anybody on base for them to drive in.
George Springer the next to hit. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. Comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. Fiftieth pitch of the game on its way. Changeup stays outside and he's behind 2-0.
You can see this guy's more focused at the plate right now. In that first AB, he went down on strikes.
They haven't played perfectly as it's hit on the ground. Beautiful diving stop. He is out. The defense on display on this beautiful diving stop at short. More baseball on the show right after this. That'll bring in Giovanni Urshela back to the top of the lineup as they're still looking for their first base runner in this one.
No doubt about that, Matt. They've yet to figure this guy out on the mound. He's looked great so far.
He has, but we'll see if this second trip through the order changes anything.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see what kind of adjustments these hitters are able to make in the middle innings of this game.
Now the pitch.
Hey, this isn't exactly the way you'd like to draw it up. Not throwing a lot of first pitch strikes, but the bottom line is he's getting outs.
Oh, he had him fooled there. No balls and two strikes. High in the air out towards shallow right. Hernandez is camped under this one, and he puts it away for the first down.
Now batting, the
digging in to try it again. Clint Frazier, first time up, he went down looking.
Yeah, always frustrating to go down looking. Everybody does it, though. You'll have a few ABs where you get completely fooled. Look for him to be on the attack early in the setback.
And he jumps at a changeup, a swing and a miss. And he fouls this one off. And he'll try and tempt him with one in the dirt, but he'll hold back here. It's 1-2. Popped him up. Kirk is there. And that's the second out of the inning.
The batter.
And that sends DJ LeMahieu into the box. Hit it hard, but lined out in his first at bat.
And that was one of the hardest hit balls they've had all game, Matty. It's been a pretty feeble effort by his teammates on the offensive side. It's going to be back to some serious tee work if he can't put that pitch in play right in his wheelhouse.
Oh, and he's finding his groove out there now. It's 0-2.
Wow, great pitch right there, right? Changing speeds. How about that straight changeup? How about that swing? Howdy, if you're waving at me.
1-2 to DJ LeMahieu.
I love a well-executed changeup, especially one down in the zone. The only problem throwing it in that situation, you leave that belt high or miss your spot just a hair, and you could have some problems.
Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number 4. And another foul ball. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball.
These are the great matchups that happen throughout the course of a game. I don't think as a pitcher you can give in right here. He's a great hitter at the plate. He knows it. You know it. Keep executing. Maybe get him to roll something over.
Just out in front of that one, still 2-2.
Four foul balls in this AB. Pitcher cannot find anywhere to go to put this guy away.
Line to the right side. That's a hit. The first of the game for the Yankees.
Dan, how frustrating that must be. Eight pitch at bat, and he's able to work a base hit.
Dero, he threw everything but the kitchen sink at him. He threw off-speed pitches, fastballs, and on the eighth pitch, left one out over the plate, just enough for a base hit.
Stepping into the box, Luke Voit. He gets a shot to hit here in the inning following the two-out single.
Yeah, and that hit might not amount to much, but anytime you could extend an inning and give a guy with plenty of pop a chance to swing it, the outlook of an inning changes dramatically.
He's set. Here it comes.
Hey, a two-out single isn't all that bad, but it can be when you've got this part of the lineup coming up.
Off the plate, one ball, one strike. Now a swing and a miss, and he's behind one and two. Just one hit apiece for both of these clubs. Bounced softly in front of the plate. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. One left for the Yankees. Through four, still tied, nothing. Welcome back to the Bronx as we check in with Heidi.
Thanks, Matt. In between innings, I was able to catch up with the manager of the Blue Jays to discuss his thoughts on his team's lineup so far. And he told me he's pretty unhappy with their discipline at the plate in this one. A lot of their outs have come from weak contact and strikeouts as a result of chasing pitches outside the strike zone. He said it's going to be extremely important for them going forward to be more selective with their swings and force the opposition to throw more strikes.
All right, Heidi, thank you. So that'll bring in Teoscar Hernandez. He'll start off the fifth in this one. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Line toward the gap in left center. That gets down. He's got himself a base hit.
We take a look at the numbers up to this point. You see he's only given up two hits so far today, so he's been hitting his spots all game long. Remains to be seen if he can keep that shutout intact going forward, but I'm not betting against him.
To the plate now, Vladimir Guerrero Jr., as he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. And that's inside and a bit low anyways. It's 2-0.
You thank your lucky stars when you get a chance to hit behind a guy with as much speed as he has on first base. The entire defense is on guard, and you know probably there's a fastball coming.
Now a throw over, back in standing. Hernandez gets his lead at first, nobody out. A 2-1 count to the Blue Jays first baseman. Has a look, now the pitch. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. The 2-2 is swung on and missed. He got him.
Well, that's just a quality pitch right there. The location was excellent because if it's put in play, there's a good chance it's on the ground for a double play. And hey, a strikeout always works too.
Now a throw over to first, and he'll get dirty, but he's back in safely. Stepping in now, Lourdes Gurriel. In the dirt here, and no advance, it's ball one. The 1-0 misses for the second ball.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
There goes the runner. Strike taken, the throw. It bounces, but he's out. Nice play there to pick the throw and put the tag on quickly.
Wow, that's a big-time throw right there, and it's a tall task to throw him out stealing a bag, but he got rid of it quickly, and it was a good job down there applying the quick tag. They'll have to feel good about that one.
No runs, two hits, and no errors in the game for Toronto. To 2-2 now. And he struck him out, his eighth punch out of the ballgame, and that one ends the inning. Down in order go the Blue Jays. Halfway home, still no score. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with the Yankees manager Aaron Boone during the break about the team's offensive performance so far, and he was pretty blunt in saying they're just not having very good at-bats. They've only managed one base runner in this game, so it's easy to see why he said they haven't shown much fight today. He's hoping to see someone step up and find a way to get something going, though. This game isn't out of hand, so it remains to be seen if they can snap out of this funk and climb back into this one.
Okay, thank you, Huddy. For the Yankees. Giancarlo Stanton now. Flied out in his first at-bat, so make him 0-for-1 so far.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
The 1-0. Line down the left field line. But this will be foul. And there's one away.
Now batting, right fielder.
And that'll bring up Aaron Judge. First delivery to him on the way.
Count 1-0.
The 1-1. Timing just to tick off there as this one's fouled off to the right. One out, nobody on. Off speed pitch, and there is strike three called. And boy, that zone just got a bit larger, two away.
Well, no preferential treatment there. Sometimes we see great hitters have their calls go their way on close pitches, but not this time. I think that was actually a good take. But on two strikes, anything that close can go either way.
At the plate, Robinson Chirinos. As he'll take a look at a pitch too low, it's ball one. One and one to Chirinos.
Hey, this guy's got to be pretty proud of what he's done so far. It's never easy to pitch on the road, but to have this kind of outing in a ballpark that is notoriously known as being hitter friendly, it's been a treat to watch.
Fastball well outside. Two out, nobody on. Swung out and missed, and it's even at 2-2.
There's a pitch we haven't seen in a while. It's going to be tough on the hitters if they have to incorporate that into their mindset.
This one misses, and that'll fill the count here. 3-2 with two away.
Looked like he tried to elevate a fastball on that 2-2 pitch there, but kind of overdid it. With a pitch that high, it's pretty easy to lay off if you're the hitter. Well, they've been unable to get to this guy, so they'll take base runners any way they can get him. At the very least, you make him work from the stretch and add to his pitch total.
So a runner at first with two away, and that'll bring up the exciting middle infielder Gleyber Torres. Ryu comes set. Here's the pitch. And he starts the number eight hitter with a strike. Nothing in one. One and one.
One ball, one strike.
Two out with the man at first. Yankee shortstop behind in the count one and two.
Yeah, Matty, you see the same pitch three times in a row and you find yourself down one and two in the count. Your head starts to get on a swivel here. Is he coming back with it four times or do I have to sit on something else?
High fly ball out to straightaway center. Springer has a read on it. And that's the third out. The Yanks leave one. Sixth inning coming up. Still zip, zip. Into the box, Rowdy Tellez. He'll lead things off against Garrett Cole.
Number 44.
First pitch coming. Here it is. Now here's a swing by Tellez as he gets a lot of this one out to deep right field. Gone to lead off the inning. A solo shot here to straightaway right field as the Jays get the game's first tally. It's 1-0.
Well, if you're going to give up a towering blast to one of the best players in their lineup, it's better to do it with no one on base. It stings, sure, but a solo shot isn't going to be the deciding factor in a game.
In now, Alejandro Kirk.
Number 85.
As the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0. He's 0-for-1 thus far. The windup and the 1-0 pitch. Fouled away. A 1-2 count to the Blue Jays signal caller. A knuckle curve there, and he thought he had him, but it's 2-2. Base is empty here with nobody out. Here's another one that's drilled. This one to left. See you later. Over the wall, a home run. A solo shot here to left as the Blue Jays take a 2-0 advantage.
Another excellent swing right there. That's multiple home runs in the same inning. Watch yourself. You're missing over the heart of the plate.
At the plate now, Kevin Biggio. As he'll take a cold strike here on a borderline pitch at strike one. Here's a curveball in the dirt that time for a ball. 1-1. Biggio, a native Texan. He was a fifth-round pick back in the 2016 first-year player draft.
Hey, this middle-round selection is still developing, but he's doing it at the big league level, and he has a lot of time to get his tool set ironed out.
Almost got him to go around, but instead it's ball three.
Even though he was fooled in the box right there by that pitch, he was able to keep his hands back, not overcommit, and stay in this at bat.
And an early birthday gift as he swings and misses at ball four.
Hey, that's the modern game right now, north-south. Elevate that high fastball and bury stuff in the dirt. Completely different from the east-west we came up playing.
So he ran the fastball by him for the punch out. Kevin Biggio becomes the first out of the inning.
Bo Bichette.
Standing in now, Bo Bichette. Yes, he'll take a tough pitch on the outside part of the plate for strike one. He went down on strikes last time up. One strike now from Cole. And he struck him out. So double digits now. 10 strikeouts for him thus far.
That's 10 strikeouts for him now. And I'll tell you, he can rack up quite a few more before he's done. Still a lot of game left in this one.
Into the box now, Marcus Semien. As he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike. 0 for 2 for him to this point. Ready with the nothing and one pitch. Started to go around there, but he holds up ball one.
Wow, that pitch wasn't even close, and he almost chased it. If I'm the pitcher, I'm going to expand the zone even more on the next one.
Outside, 2-1. Now here it comes. And it's 2 balls and 2 strikes now.
Everything this guy throws is hard. That changeup he throws is in the high 80s to go along with that good heater.
And that misses there, so he runs the count full now.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
And he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four.
What's the saying? When you find yourself in a hole, the first thing you should do is stop digging. Well, the guy on the bump obviously hasn't heard that one.
Digging in once again, George Springer. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. Here comes the first pitch. Set to deliver the 0-1. Now a fastball off the plate away, a ball and a strike. Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact.
You know, he was really pounding the strike zone early on, but he's kind of gotten away from that here a bit. He might just need a little reminder to attack hitters and trust his stuff.
Well above the letters with the fastball that time.
Well, this has been a long inning already, and I know he doesn't want it to get any longer. I expect a challenge pitch right here.
A runner on first with two away. And there he goes toward second. Strike called. Now the throw down is not close as he's in there with a stolen base. Here comes the payoff pitch. Count remains full. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. Good battle. Count remains full. Another payoff pitch. And this pitch misses here as well. Back-to-back walks now, but at least that'll put the force back in order here.
Now batting, the right fielder, Teoscar.
And now the Toronto number four hitter, Teoscar Hernandez. And we'll see what he can do here. Two on, two away, two home so far this inning. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch.
That was a pretty good fastball after he walked the hitter previous. There was a little angry on that heater.
Here comes the 0-1. Breaking ball below the zone. That's ball one. Double barreled action in the Yankee bullpen now. A lefty and a right-hander start to get loose. Two down, runners at first and second. A little bit outside. 2-1.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be really aggressive. With two guys already on, pretty good shot. He's going to get a challenge pitch right here.
Go, A little too tall that time. 3-1 now.
This is a spot you'd like to be in as a good hitter. Runners in scoring position and count leverage in your favor.
Out of the stretch, here's his 3-1 home. Hit weakly back to the mound. Throw is in time, and they're able to avoid the huge inning here as the side is retired. So two runs come across here, both coming via the solo home run. 9-1-2 scheduled to hit in the home half of the sixth. It's the Blue Jays 2 and the Yankees nothing. Digging in the switch hitter, Aaron Hicks. He'll start things out in their half of the sixth as they look to shake things up here for a lineup that, quite frankly, has been non-existent to date.
No doubt about that, Matt. They've been completely overmatched to this point. One hit through five innings. I mean, what else can you say about the pitching they faced other than it's been fantastic? We'll see if that continues as we approach the later inning.
First offering on its way.
Hey!
Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Set up away with the changeup, but it's 1-1. And that fastball's too much for him there, 1-2.
Well, you know you've got it working on the mound when they're swinging right through it, even when you're putting it right down the middle of the strike zone. Not the greatest of game plans, though.
And he'll step on first for the out, 3 unassisted.
Now batting.
Ready once again, Gio Urshela. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Here comes the first pitch. Hit out towards second. Simeon's got it. And there are two away now.
The batter.
Standing in, Clint Frazier. He's 0 for 2 with a strikeout in this one. Ryu gets the sign. First pitch on its way. Swing and a liner. But this won't get by the shortstop as he's there to take it in for the third out. So the Yanks go 1-2-3. They're still down. It's 2-0. Darren O'Day is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7.
Number 56. Darren O'Day.
Coming to the plate now, Vladimir Guerrero Jr., 1-for-2. He singled and struck out in two trips.
Guerrero Jr.
First pitch of the at bat, and that misses ball one. Hit hard up the middle, and there's a base hit, so maybe some insurance here to lead off the seventh.
There's a hard hit ground ball, pitcher not able to get a glove on it. Hard single up the middle.
Yeah, watch your lips right there, Dad. Sent it back right where it came from.
So now to the plate, Lourdes Gurriel, as he takes a called strike at the knees. It's 0-1. O'Day, the former Baltimore Oriole, he came here by way of trade earlier this year.
I know he'd tell you he'd like to be playing a little bit better, but I think it's as advertised for this ball club right now. I think the manager is getting exactly what they expected.
Behind 0-2 now.
He's got that certainly timed up now. I'd be shocked if the pitcher goes to the well 3 times in a row with off speed.
Not a bad pitch there with 2 strikes, but it misses 1-2. From the belt, the pitch. And this one's in the dirt, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. The 2-2.
3-2.
That was another good pitch and a tough call that could have gone either way. He couldn't get him to bite on it again, so the count's gone from 0-2 to 3-2.
Nobody out, runner on first. This one's flared toward left center. Coming on for it is Hicks, but he won't get there. It falls in.
Now batter, number 44.
Rowdy Tellez will stand in yet again as we flash you back to the middle innings. This was a turning point here. A solo home run that was really one of the key at-bats of the ballgame to this point. First offering on its way.
Ball that's outside.
Well, the Blue Jays have been searching for that big hit pretty much all game. They're hoping they get it right now. This would sure be a good time.
The 1-0 delivery. And he fires in a strike this time to make it one ball and one strike.
Well, he's following the code not to miss down and into a lefty. Everything on the outer half of the plate.
None out, runners at first and second.
Ball two.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Those were two great executed pitches right there away from this batter. He can hurt you in a heartbeat. I don't think anything's going to leak out over the heart of the plate.
Good slider there. Gets a swing and miss. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
And he can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an 8-pitch at-bat.
It's been a really rough day for this lineup. There's really no other way to say it. Not a lot of good scoring opportunities, and when they've had them, like right now, it's just been an uphill battle for them to make anything positive happen.
At the plate, Alejandro Kirk. As the first pitch here has been high, it's ball one. A hit and two tries for him so far. Now a good pitch around the knees, but it doesn't quite catch the bottom of the zone.
Got to find a way to execute either a good fastball down and away or flip something off speed for a strike. You cannot miss over the heart of the plate in these situations. The hitter is on high alert.
Too tight with that one. 3-0.
Well, nothing can make you question yourself on that mound more than three straight balls to a guy you know that you should go right after. Sometimes you just lose the strike zone and you don't know why.
And he'll just make him throw one over here. 3-1.
3-1 with 2-1, and this is where you got to be geared up for something to drive. I don't think you can just groove him one right here. You still have to try to make a competitive pitch.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. Oh, on the ground to short. Could this be two? LeMahieu for one. And an offline throw, but he puts the tag on for route number three. So they pick up no runs on two base hits, no errors, and one man left on base. Seventh inning stretch time here at the ballpark. The Jays are out in front, 2-0. Leading off the inning, DJ LeMahieu, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up.
Starting to run out of time. They haven't been able to score any runs as we're moving late into this one. A perfect time for this leadoff guy to try to get on base and ignite a rally.
First pitch on its way.
Every ball club has that spark plug guy, and this is the guy right here. He usually ignites a lot of productive innings.
This is line to left. And he will make the catch while ranging backward as he just put the glove up and hauled it in for the first down.
Well, he hit that ball pretty well, but the only problem was that he pulled off it just a bit. The location was a little on the outer half, so he would have hit it even better if he would have stayed through the middle of the field with it.
Riding in once again, Luke Voit. No hits to this point. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Now some definite signs of life in that Toronto bullpen. Both a lefty and a right-hander begin to throw. Barely able to make contact. Down 0-2 now. And he wastes a fastball high there, 1-2.
Pretty standard fastball right there, 0-2. Now he's changed the eye level of the batter so he can start working something in like an off-speed curveball down in the zone.
The 2-2. A bouncer to the left side. That's through, and he's got his first base hit. He's 1-for-3.
I mean, that has to frustrate the guy on the mound right there. You get him down 0-2, no put-away pitch, works the count back to neutral, and is able to mix in a base hit. Nice job.
In now, Giancarlo Stanton, as the changeup to him drops in there for the first strike.
We're moving along into the later innings, and this guy's throwing over 60% of his first pitches for strikes. He'd like to do a little bit more, but so far, so good.
Easy take there as the off-speed pitch misses well inside. Popped up. Kirk has a play. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away.
The right fielder, number 99.
So it's a runner at first with two men out, and that'll bring up the big bat of Aaron Judge. Ryu comes set. Here's the pitch. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. Skied into straightaway right. Hernandez is in pursuit. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning. One left for the Yankees. They're down 2-0. Matt Bowman has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 67, Matt Bowman.
Leading off the inning, Kevin Biggio, as they'll look for some added insurance before the bottom half of the inning.
Number 8, Kevin Biggio.
First pitch coming, here it is. Fouled off. The windup and the 0-1. Ripped down the line, but this will wind up a foul ball, strike two. He struck him out, the third time he's fanned in the game.
If you've got a good fastball going and they're not handling, keep throwing it. Right there, three fastballs in a row. He gone.
Bichette.
At the plate now, Bo Bichette. As he takes a called strike on the black, it's 0-1. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. I had him reaching at thin air that time, and he's very quickly down 0-2.
Ew, was that ugly. You could probably throw anything out there to this guy. He'd swing at the rosin bag if you throw it up there.
Protecting on 0-2, so we'll do it again. Ripped down the first baseline, but this will wind up foul, still 0-2. Another one sent foul. Tries the slider to ring him up, but he lays off 1-2.
After multiple pitches were fouled off, it gets a little disappointing as a pitcher. So you think, say, I'm going to throw one way off the plate and see if he'll chase it. Didn't happen.
Yanked the slider across that time, laid off for a ball. Hit hard on the ground to short. Torres picks it up. And that's the second out. So digging in now, Marcus Semien, 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. He's ready. Here's the first offering. And that's by him. It's 0-1.
It's not easy to get your barrel to a pitch that high. That can be an effective location as long as he keeps it above the letters.
Semien in an 0-2 hole here. And it's fouled away. Bases are empty here with two men out. Grounded straight into the shift on the left side. He's got it. Throw on to Voit takes care of him, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Blue Jays as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. Bottom of the inning now, and that'll bring in the veteran catcher, Robinson Chirinos.
Even though we're moving into the back end of this game, they're only down by a couple of runs. You know that old slogan, a bloop and a blast? They could certainly use that right now.
And who looks like he got the call there on the pitch inside. It's 0-1. Now here it comes. Ground ball sent back up the middle, and this is going to scoot on through into center for a base hit leading off the inning.
You know, D-Row, there's been some great pitching in this one so far. After that knock, that's only the third hit of the game, and we're getting late into this one.
Yeah, they always say you got to tip your hat to the opposition sometimes. Well, I think this offense is tired of tipping its hat. They got to start to swing the bats a little bit better. That's their third knock of the game. I know it's late, but maybe they can get something going.
Torres stands in for the third time now as he takes a look at a ball. It's 1-0. A runner at first with no outs here. Right side, but it's going to be a foul ball. He's set. Here comes the 1-1.
Nope, at the ball.
One of the things you want to do with a starter, get that pitch count up. Here's another productive at bat as this count now gets to 3 balls and 2 strikes.
Here comes the payoff pitch. This is on the ground over to first. And that is into right field, a base hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
Now batting.
You know, as a former infielder, Danny, they always say you can't be in two places at once, but you got to be a little frustrated right here that ball found the hole.
Yeah, that's a tough thing. You make a quality pitch, and a guy shoots one through the right side, normally a vacated spot right there. 9 out of 10 times, somebody's there to make that play. Unfortunately, not, and now we've got a couple of guys on.
So now the Jays manager will make his way out toward the mound, and that will be the last we see in this one of Hyunjin Ryu. So he'll leave with the lead. Can't lose this one, but he is responsible for the two runners out there, so he could get a no decision if they were to come around and score. David Phelps comes on now in an awfully difficult situation as there are two on here with nobody out. Aaron Hicks will be his first test out of the bullpen, and it'll be a tough test indeed as he'll face him with two on and nobody out here. From the stretch, and that's dead center for strike one.
Well, the Yankees have been searching for that big hit pretty much all game. It remains to see if they can get it, but now sure would be a good time.
That's in there, and he's deep in the hole now, 0-2.
That's the exact spot to lean on as a reliever. As a hitter, you just have to tip your cap and look for the next one.
Here comes the nothing and two pitch, and the knuckle curve that time got him swinging, and that's the first out.
The batter.
So the lineup flips over, and digging in, Gio Urshela. He's hitless in three at bats to this point. First pitch of the at bat on its way.
0-1.
Hit down the line at first, but this will be a foul ball as he's behind 0-2 now.
Not surprised he's laid on a heater right there. Just saw an off-speed pitch, wanted to stay back a little bit too long.
Count is 1-2 now. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. Now a ball lined to the left side, but this is a foul ball. Can't find the zone there as he lays off the breaking ball.
I don't think he can afford another base runner here, so whatever pitch he feels best about, whichever one he feels most comfortable with, that's the one I expect him to turn to.
Seventh pitch of the at-bat coming up. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. And, oh, he missed a home run by a matter of feet. It's off the wall.
When this thing left the bat, I thought it had three-run homer written all over it, but it bounces off the wall, so only one run scores. And now a chance for his buddy to return the favor and bring in one or maybe two.
Brett Gardner will be summoned now to be the pinch runner.
Number 11, Brett.
Digging in now, Clint Frazier. Been a rough go of things at the plate for him so far, but his guys are looking for him to change that right here.
Yeah, nothing better than coming through for the boys in a tight game, Matt, especially when you're kind of due to do something productive.
First pitch on its way, and he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1.
Got to sit middle when a guy's trying to pitch around you. If he's going to give you first base, take it.
A one pitch on its way. And there's ball one. A ball and two strikes.
I kind of like the aggressive attitude right here. I know he's in a jam. What does he do? He goes to his best stuff, and that's the fastball.
The 1-2. Weak grounder back to the mound. Throw gets him. Two down.
The batter. The second
so
baseman.
Stepping in, DJ LeMahieu, as he's got a chance to tie this ball game up with that equalizing run just 90 feet away at third. Trying to hold the lead, here's the delivery. Called strike at the letters, 0-1.
Hey, I don't have a problem with him taking a pitch right there. It's a good opportunity to see what he's got. Also a good opportunity to see if he's going to be pounding the strike zone.
Down the third baseline, but that'll get foul. It's 0-2 now. Big spot. Two out, possible tying and go-ahead runs on base. Swing and a miss on the knuckle curve, and the inning is over. So it's a run on three hits, no errors, and two men left on. We've played eight full. The Blue Jays on top, 2-1. Zach Britton enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. Miguel Andujar has come into the ballgame now as he takes over as the new third baseman.
Miguel Andujar.
All set to start the ninth in this one. And coming forward, the veteran outfielder, George Springer.
The center fielder, George Springer.
Here's the first pitch to him.
Hey, great job pounding the zone, strike one. When you got a great hitter in the box, got to get ahead. Count leverage is a must.
Drilled to the right side. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. Stepping in, Teoscar Hernandez. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. He's set and the pitch. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. The 1-0.
2-0.
Bases are empty, one man out. And a very low strike there. Trying to speed up the game, perhaps. It's 2-1. A bouncer up the middle. A dive, but he can't get it. It's through into the outfield.
Hey, they weren't going to keep this guy down for long. That's the ebbs and flows of a baseball season. Bottom line is this guy has bat to ball skills. You knew he was going to get hot eventually.
To the plate now, Vladimir Guerrero Jr. as the sinker to him finds the zone for strike one. So far, 2-for-3 in this one. And he fouls this one off. Now the 0-2 pitch. lifted in the air out towards left center. Stanton giving chase. He makes the play. Really had to hustle to get to that one. Two gone now.
The batter.
In now, Nordis Gurriel. He's got a hit in three at bats to this point. Throw over to the bag. He's ready. Here's the first offering.
Count 1-0.
The 1-0. A swing and a miss, strike one.
1-1.
I think it's about time to choke up on that bat and get that foot down. He's awfully tardy right now.
Slider is in there, and now it's 1-2. To two balls and two strikes now. Fouled away. Again, another foul ball. The 2-2 one more time. Takes this the other way to right, and that's in there. Base hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now.
The batter, number 44.
Stepping in now, Rowdy Tellez. Yes, he'll take a look at ball one. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate. The set and the 1-0. Weak grounder down the first baseline. Throw on to first is in time, and the Toronto rally goes for naught as the inning is over. Blue Jays leave a pair. They still lead it 2-1. Kirby Yates takes the ball now in inning number 9, looking to close the door.
Number 39, Kirby Yates.
All set for the bottom of the ninth. And here comes the first baseman, Luke Voit.
The first baseman, Luke Voit.
Comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Ready with the nothing and one pitch. And it's 1-1. Yates, 33 years old. He was taken in the 26th round back in 2005.
Man, coming out of the late rounds, you have to grind for everything. Nothing is given to you. And this guy has turned himself into a very solid big league ball player. That's a big accomplishment.
Fouled off. Ready on 1-2. And right into the shift. On to first, and that is a huge out to start the bottom of the ninth.
Now back.
Blue Jays are into their bullpen now, as there are the final numbers for their starter, and he'll be very happy with how the day went.
Yeah, he looked really dialed in from start to finish. This is the kind of outing you hope for every time you go out there. So I think he'll feel pretty good about the effort he put forth in this one.
So now to the plate, Giancarlo Stanton, as he'll swing and miss at a first pitch slider at strike one. He could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far. 0-1 delivery. And that fastball's taken but catches the outer third. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 0-2 pitch. And that's a swinging strike three in the dirt. And the throw to first is there to record the second out.
You know, professional catchers make those plays look easy most of the time, but that was a big play that shouldn't go unnoticed. Had he found a way on, he would have represented a tying run. So that was a nice job there to make sure that strikeout didn't get wasted.
The Yankees down to their final out. And that'll bring up the former American League Rookie of the Year, Big Aaron Judge. From the stretch, here's the pitch. The fastball here is he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. Fans on their feet in a one-run ball game in the last of the ninth.
That's a ball.
That misses, 2-0.
2-0.
And the pitch. Slapped hard the opposite way. And he'll put this one away, and with that, the ball game is over.
Hey, it's hard to win games at any point, but to win games on the road, especially in this ballpark, so they are very happy with this win.
Pitching and defense game, 2-1, the final score this afternoon. Toronto rode an important sixth inning to victory in this one. Hyunjin Ryu earns the victory on the mound. Garrett Cole struck out 10 in the losing effort. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.
Fans, our final line score this afternoon. First for the victorious Blue Jays, 2 runs on 8 hits.